Okay, this is a little bit different. We're in my studio. So I'm going to do a reading, collective reading. Hello, everybody. Holy Spirit, I feel like I need my glasses on. Couch in my studio. Thought I'd change settings. This is one of my paintings here. I don't even remember what year I did that. I haven't got a year right now. Most of them I have years written on my paintings. I've got illusions here. So, yeah, my painting here is. It's about death and rebirth, so it's like she looks very sad because she is there's a renewal, a rebirth, and it's kind of like that connection to earth with a connection with earth and see how. In the painting we've got, this is sort of like the DNA transformation. DNA transformation, I hope I'm being loud enough. And having the nature, this regrowth here, and the green running through the veins, that's like nature, the nature running through one's veins, but we have a having a new DNA activation. Okay. And there's illusions surrounding this. Hang on, let me put this in right here. Trying to make myself comfy. Oh, we've got Nine of Swords in reverse. So we've got illusions, the Seven of Cups. And then we've got the Nine of Swords in reverse. So collective, this illusions about somebody not being regretful about Ten of Swords. There's illusions about not being regretful about some sort of Ten of Swords situation. Not looking back. This is like not looking back, regretting. Juggling. Two of Pentacles. Juggling options. Okay, so there's illusions about not caring. Illusions about not caring about past situations. It's like this painting here, right? And she's sad about letting go. So this is illusions about the collective not caring about having to. It's like somebody feels like they're being tennis oars, like stabbed in the back, because the collective have had to. So there's illusions about not caring, about having to move on, to let go. About it's not like the collective doesn't care, it's that it's like having to, you know, and that's what this painting's about, like this sadness here. It's like having to move on, to let go, to rebirth this new generation. Like having to get let go of all of the past. And for somebody, it feels like they've been stabbed in the back. Okay, it's an illusion though that this Queen of Swords, right, has had to cut out. Right. And to receive these new downloads, that's what these particles are in this painting. So to be able to receive the new DNA upgrades, the collective have had to let go of a lot, and they realize this. Other people feel like they're being stabbed in the back because the collective has had to move on, let go. That's what it is. It's a renewal, having to let go of the old, the past. You know, like it's always sad. It's always sad when things have to be let go of. It's like a necessary thing to say that, so the collective can move on to the new, you know. And it's like that with everything. It's that's life, you know. There's death and then rebirth, right? We have the Queen of Wands. So we've got the Queen of Swords and we've got the Queen of Wands here. As well. We've got two queens. The Ten of Swords. Why is the Ten of Swords here? There is a deception. Seven of Swords. There is something going on here that the collective do need to be aware of. Something to do with the Queen of Wands. Could be a fire sign, but it doesn't really, you know, like there's no empathy here. Page of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. Four of Cups, two of Wands. So we have two of Wands. Got the Ten of Pentacles. comes when it's in its upright is like longing and making a decision about a direction. Looking out. But this is in reverse. So there's not that longing feeling for the Ten of Pentacles here. Left out in the cold. There's like a real sadness here. It's just like this painting. I feel like I'm drawing all the energy out of this painting, and there's a reason why I sat here in front of this painting today. Got the devil at the bottom of the deck. Exposure with the sun and the guard with the fool. There's a King of Pentacles and the Empress is showing up, the Knight of Cups. So there's a Knight of Cups, could be Cancer, Pisces, or a Scorpio, coming to bring a small offer or an apology to the Empress. And I think it's a King, it is a King of Pentacles, okay? About a new beginning. Been asked to keep our guards up because this is the Seven of Wands. We've got the Seven of Swords here as well. Something's been exposed. Some devil energy has been exposed with the sun here. Something's coming fast. There's a Knight of Wands. There's a Knight of Pentacles, sorry. Behind that is a King of Wands. There's a King of Wands coming fast. It's confusing me because we've got a Knight of Pentacles, which is slow moving. It's like a stable energy. Well, there's a King of Wands offering stability. There's a King of Wands offering stability, but coming in fast. But we've been told to keep our guard up because, so there's an apology with this, because the devil energy is here. And we have the Seven of Swords here, and we've got that Ten of Swords there as well. Okay? Queen of Swords is in the five. We have the Five of Cups. There's illusions about this though, right? This regret. There's illusions about the regret. is in reverse. It's in reverse this time. With the Queen of Wands, could be fire sign. Something not working here. There's karma here for a Queen of Wands. Something is not over. The stagnant position for this. So we've got a King of Swords in reverse. But this person's like really nasty. In this family. Six of Cups. But they're going. It's not over for them, this stagnant situation. It's like a stalemate feeling. It's not over. And this is the karma for work. A work situation. It's like the remorse is an illusion, like fake. The Queen of Swords can be a Gemini, Aquarius, or a Libra. The Queen of Wands here, the devil energy is in reverse, with no regret, with this Nine of Swords in reverse. We've got the Lovers. Again, but I meant the Ten of Pentacles. So we've got the Ten of Swords, and then we've got the Ten of Pentacles. So it's like to do with money. So it's like, and then we've got the Six of Pentacles. Yeah, the end of money, right? Like, so somebody is trying to stop. Someone's trying to stop the collective's balance in money with the High Priestess here. Cut, see? Two swords. Someone's trying to cut the collective financial, cut the collective's financial growth. Somebody's trying to cut the collective's financial growth and keep them juggling with the Two of Pentacles here and the Five of Pentacles. Five of Pentacles. The of Swords. It was in reverse though. I think. Yeah, it's in reverse, and it just knocked the Ten of Swords. Judgment and the Ace of Wands. Yeah, look, there's black magic there. It's the King of Swords, right? We've got the Magician in reverse, we've got Judgment and the Ace of Wands, and the Two of Swords. Investments. So, what the collective are investing in, this King of Swords in reverse is doing. This Magician in reverse is doing, like, is make on judging the collective moves on a new beginning, and they're trying to stop the new beginning. Three of Cups in reverse with black magic. So, protections, collective. Keep the guard up, keep the protection up against this person, this King of Swords in reverse. It's a tyrant. This person's a tyrant. Queen of Swords. Somebody's not well. Or they're hungover, drinking too much. Options. Queen of Swords, Gemini or Aquarius. Somebody's, this is like hungover, regretful. You know, like being on the terps all night. That's what I'm getting here, but there's Seven of Cups as well as the Five of Cups. I'm drinking a lot. Queen of Wands. For in any way, I think they might be Queen of Wands, or they just don't give a fuck. Queen of Swords, so we've got an air sign and we've got a fire sign. Lovers, and we've got the Lovers again. Look, see, that's not his thoughts in reverse. Yeah, like not. Clarify. partnership here. There's no partnership. Like loveless. Oh, it's like even worse than that. Like hatred. Sad news. Ten of Pentacles, Seven of Wands. Occupation. Keep your guard up. Or somebody's keeping their guard up. A work situation. A lot of money. Someone's defensive about an occupation. And we've got the gift and the small child in reverse. Of a gift, and they're defensive about putting money first. Somebody's defensive about putting money before a child, which was the gift, and I no longer have that, lost that gift. And this is what this sad news is, you know, because of this backstabbing and this deceit. Seven of Swords and this creation and this legal matter. What is this legal matter? Was a main female, privileged lady, main female. Has a legal issue. What is this Five of Swords in reverse? Left out in the cold. Five of Swords in reverse. Left out in the cold. We have murky thoughts. Five. Murky thoughts. Five of Pentacles. Not left. Somebody feels like they've been stolen from. What is this? Or somebody is thinking about I feel more like somebody is feels like they've been stolen from, like they've lost a lot of money out in the cold, juggling. Because she looks like she's kind of sitting there looking like, and it's like she's contemplating loss. Just give me 2 seconds, I think I'm gonna have to turn the heater back on. So yeah, somebody's very sad. Out in the car, feeling like they've lost a lot. Because somebody was trying to stop the collective from progressing. That's what we're getting at here. You know, like with the finances, so they were trying to put a stop to it, to stop moving, stop draw. Thank you. this is like saying, hold on to your money. Because Alaric was like a Germanian, right? Like they were like the natives of the north, northern countries in Europe, and they, the Germanians, you know, they lived, you know, like our indigenous people here. You know, they lived close to the earth. They, you know, just built stick humpies, and they lived with the. The earth, and they weren't against, you know, like living against it. That's the Roman ideal, you know, like, you know, building the dams and you know, like controlling everything and putting us into this society that we live in today. And Alaric here, he was a Viking king who was very much for you know, like holding on to that they were about moving, you know, with the seasons. He was about protecting nature, basically living with the earth, not against it. And what I'm getting from this, and it's saying about there's restrictions in this partnership here, with this legal matter, the stabbing in the back and the Seven of Swords, with a money situation, like this is like giving you a systems situation, right? Occupation, work and money. So this can be like a global scale of things, but also a personal, down-to-earth scheme of things. And we've got a loss of a child and the gifts because of an occupation. Because of money. Because of money. Safe, stop walking because look what's here. There's a dark situation going on here. Oh, we're talking about Alaric, and we've got, this is the Raven Village, right? Causing the illness. Spirit, like small scale. Because we've got the lovers and the deceit, right? And then, oh, this is a legal matter. This could be a past situation. It's backstabbing. Well, yeah, well, all of that is the past. I was just talking about with Albert. We have a legal situation. Illegal couplings, you know, like, work, this is like, and then we've got loss of children and a gift for money, oh my goodness, this is like trafficking. God himself and Albert. Situation here. I mean, there's a stalker. There's a stalker, and you know, like we've had the RAPD come up, and the stalker come up twice. So, we need to be on guard, and that's why we've got the that's why we've got the Seven of Wands here as well. Yeah, look behind. Three, Two of Wands, stay behind. Somebody's following, and that's why we have the Two of Wands in reverse. There's a rabbit. Let me show you this. I just looked over and noticed this. Look. Reduce speed, right? This is a painting I've done on an old reduce speed sign, right? And I put the hand on it because I'm talking about, you know, like reducing... reducing speed, reducing drug intake, right? So that's significant. So somebody might be a drug user. That's what I'm getting. Okay. Fight. Might be a fight going to break out here, and we've got the bottom of the barrel. Someone is on the bottom of the barrel. What else can you tell us here, Spirit? What else can you tell us? This is significant, right? So this is a significant message. I knew I had to do one of these. Cyrus is here. Cyrus is the Persian from the Persian Empire, 590 to 580 BC was his reign. Cyrus was also a, you know, like this, the Persian Empire. He was also about, like, the amalgamations of the different cultures, but living in peace, you know, like together. It's about that. This is about being at peace with and being accepting, like, of all different races and cultures. So significant when we're talking about, you know, like living close to the earth, you know, the indigenous communities, and how, you know, rape and pillage and everything come and steal their worlds, their countries, their lands, their worlds, their way of being, their way of life, everything. And so Cyrus is about bringing them all together and accepting all of them in the one's, you know, empire. He wasn't about you know, like stealing culture. He was about more embracing the cultures, embracing others' cultures, and, you know, like growing. Like, see, if we bring all the cultures together, then we elevate, because we all learn different things from different cultures, right? Everyone's got something different to offer. It's like with any, any group of people, every single one of those different people have all got something different to offer. And that then elevates the collective as a group, right? Right, and this is where we're at this elevation stage. But we have to come together. While we're getting this other negative stuff, I think this is the resistance to that. It's the resistance to that amalgamation of culture. It's a resistance. It's like, because some people want to keep it separate, right? Some people want to keep us separate, but we can't be anymore because we're already together across the world, across the board. So we have to accept each other because we're all in each other's space. So this is to do with the past loss and how it's made everybody, a lot of people, ill. And then I was talking about reduced speed, like the drug problem, and stop the walking, stop that movement towards more illness, stop the movement towards more illness. With all these options of options of different drugs and alcohol and, you know, all that, it's just putting people in the five of cups, you know, like all these options of speed and amphetamines and alcohol, and it's just leaving everybody like this and making everybody ill, right? Here we have clouded. It's making people clouded. Because it does, it stops that pineal gland, you know, like it clogs it all up. And it keeps us small minded. We've got a Queen of Wands here that's got the Devil in reverse and not remorseful and is rich. But then we've got this sadness here and a legal situation. So all this past stuff is causing some legal issues, right? Like across the board. And we've got occupation here and the loss of a child. Occupation, it's got defend, the pentacles, the family, ten of pentacles, and the occupation, defend, defend, because we're losing our children, defend, we need to be defending our children, which are our gifts. It's a loss of children and gifts. Well, the children are the gifts, right? Wow. Juggling, left out in the cold for unexpected money. It's messy. It's messy, all right, and we got stressed. So all our communities are messy and stressed because of this, and this is what it's stemmed from. And it's all to do with greed and wanting more, and that comfort that everybody goes, you know, like strives for, which they believe that their happiness and their contentment comes from the money but it's just done the complete opposite because we've lost our children and our gifts, culture, and it's the culture that holds everyone together and, you know, protects the children. But the whole society has just turned to money, you know, and it's stolen our real gifts. Oh, again. Seeing. God sees this. This legal matter is to do with, and this backstabbing with the Ten of Swords here, this legal matter and the Seven of Swords is, and the sad news is that realization of putting money before our own children even, and even, allowing the RAPE to take place because of our love of money. Shh, it says again, somebody doesn't want us to say, but look who's here again. He has seen it all. And look who else is here. Jesus, we've got Jesus and God himself. Seeing it all, you know, because our society has just put money before our children, and this is how we've lost our gifts. It's made our whole society ill. But see, that was a war tactic, you know, that stealing the children and everything. It was an absolute premeditated thing, you know. They knew what they were doing. They used the churches for it, so they simultaneously corrupted the religion. Hold back. The Spirit says, hold back. Isaiah, hold back and be frugal. We've got snakes. So, need to read Isaiah page 462 and 322. Spirit says, hold back and sing. Get messages the other day, I was hearing, you know, like the children sing. Oh my gosh, I'm getting really emotional. There's been a lot of children lost. And it wasn't just that first, that, you know, like those stolen, it's the generations after that. Isaiah keeps jumping out again. Spy. And video. That's what the message is, collective. The collective are people with messages that are speaking out about this are being watched and threatened with this stalker, gang stalking, and RAPE as well. So hold back, Spirit says. It's messy again. Spy again. See? Being watched. Spy, messy. Stressed. Animals. Messy. Stressed animals. Well, they are animals. Keeps coming up. Stressed. Fake. Again. Driver just fell in my lap. Contract. There's a driver and a contract. Been contracted to drive. Bottom of the barrel. Oh my God. This is a known war tactic. It's used for the demasculation of men and it's the bottom of the barrel shit, right? And the humiliation and, you know, it's just a whole lot is bottom of the barrel shit. Domination. Under the moon at night, wishing. Somebody wishing this for the collective? Stressed again. Animals. The animals are stressed as well. Oh my God. Didn't I bring up that there? Oh. People are even doing this to animals. And then we've got rooster. I said the other week, it came up in one of the other readings about how people are just so badly corrupted, and our society is so badly corrupted that people were, like somebody in our community, and it was only a very young man, old teen, he wasn't even a man yet. Fucking chickens, and then rooster came up, sodomy then. Animals. See, this is out of hand. This is how we're losing our people to absolute abominations, we will call it. Yep. Oh my God, we have MK Ultra. Mind control in the sky. This is what's going on. See, that's how they do it. We've got real estate here for some reason. Why is real estate? I don't know why real estate has anything to do with it. Land. Well, this is how they've been able to control the nations, is actually using this disgusting humiliation program and using MK Ultra. Well, this is what it is, right? How they use mind control with trauma and humiliation. They managed to be able to then manipulate the population. And they can make people do things that they wouldn't normally do, like that, because they've already programmed people. So people are traumatized. What they did in the early, way back, or they actually came out of the royal families, this, I don't know how far back this went, but with human corruption, they used you know, like trauma tactics to control the people, right? So what they would do is, if you bring up a child, and this was all tied in with stolen children, right? Stolen generations. If you take a child from 3 years old, or if you bring up a child, right, in a nurturing place, and they feel safe, and they're given a handler, and they're first being able to experience love and safety and, you know, like all those good things. And then, and so, like, when they get to like 3 years old, put those children into like trauma, like, and they would use like sexual abuse and violence to traumatize them so that they can disassociate the brain, the front lobe, so that they can be controlled with triggers, and then they can be turned on and off to behave in any way they want, like hypnosis, right? They just like click and bang, you know, they can get you to do whatever they want, and that's what's going on. And then they so they're doing this to the people, and they're getting people to do all sorts of disgusting things, and then blackmailing with videos of people doing disgusting things, and then they hang themselves because they can't live with themselves, even though it wasn't actually in their right mind. But this is what's going on with the drugs and everything as well. They use that as a means to get to people. Damn. If, listen, like, if you've got children right now, keep them close. And, you know, like, fall into the stars. Tax evasion we've got here as well. A lot of the triggers, so a lot of people are already been traumatized, like after the stolen generations. And then of course what happens is that they, in a lot of cases, they then continue trauma, because they haven't dealt with their traumas, the trauma gets passed down the lineages and in the blood, and infects all the bloodlines, right? So, and then, you know, like this is a long-term tactic, and then they've used the media, you know, like they started off with, you know, radio, TV, and then internet, and you know, like now, you know, all the social media and all that, movies, they plant triggers in there that can set people off to do specific things, like a switch, so they can use the portal of the phone, of the computer, of the TV, of the music, and they can trigger people to do things. And this is also murders. They also used this tactic to create spies so that they can switch the brain off and the person forgets. They don't even remember they've done it, right? Because their brain's been turned on and off. And that's that disassociation thing. They don't remember. They don't remember because they've been switched off. And that's how they created spies and also sex slaves. This is what we're talking about here. Children. This is what has to be healed. This is what has to be recognized and seen for what it is. Because this is still within our system. That we're all been programmed to live in. So this needs to be recognized so that our communities can heal across the board. Doesn't matter what color you are, because this is across the board. This has happened to everybody. Everybody. All races, all colored skins. That's why I painted this person blue. Not just that it's an avatar. Damn, okay. We need to exercise this forgiveness as well for a lot of people. Like, once people start coming out of these spells, because this is what it is, it's spell work, it's spells, you know. Think about those. You know, the spell work from the magicians and the hypnosis. But we see we need to forgive our people because we need to understand that the whole society is under hypnosis. And it's not really them. And this is how we can forgive. So, but we have to forgive each other because for the things that have happened. Because nobody's been in their right mind. They're only just all waking up now, out of it, you know? Because it's caused people so much guilt and shame, and it doesn't even really come from them. Let me show you another picture. This picture here. And the daffodils represent her children, right? And it's called the burden of creation because the mother is responsible for what they create. And she looks pretty silly with these daffodils growing out of her head, right? And so it causes shame. The shame aspect of what you create, what you do in your life, world is how you are being seen, right? So these tactics of war which they've used, these tactics of war have destroyed all the communities, and then using videos to reproject it onto people, and people can't live with themselves. And you know, like in our community, the amount of people that are taking their own lives is just like it, that is the pandemic. It is. That's the pandemic. You know. But we need to know what's going on in